you.
We needed to have a way to track early development quantitatively. So far, all the methods that we have, they are based on visual observation. They need a lot of expertise, and still they are quite qualitative. And they would not allow you to track the same child as he develops.
In the clinics, we have very limited time to get an overall idea of child's performance. Very often, infants may be a bit worried about the situation, even scared. So we really appreciate the opportunity to have something which is from their natural, everyday environment.
Biggest innovation, in my view, what we did was come up with a motor ability description scheme, which tries to objectively quantify in a second-to-second fashion on what an infant is doing. So we detect the posture of the child, and then we, for each posture, we then try to detect the quality of the movement.
A very specific target could be those infants who have very severe motor or sensory difficulties, like you know, visual impairment. So in the long run, I think this might provide a tool to really sort of aim the intervention.
The same paradigm that we are now using to detect the motor maturity of infants could be also scaled to older kids or adults.
When you bring this wearable to a new environment, it could be a different area in Finland, but it could also be any corner of the world. It brings the same expertise in the diagnostics to that area. In that sense, we feel that this kind of solution is creating equality, significant equality for healthcare.